something to eat before Popeye's closed. The Bible said in Genesis 35 and 1, I don't care who came with me, if y'all don't like Popeye's, go where you want to go. It don't make no difference. I got no praises here. The Bible said in Genesis 35 and 1, and God said unto Jacob, wait now, in Genesis 35, we find that the Lord is speaking directly, I'll throw you the mic in a minute, to Jacob. But now a few chapters later, he changes his name from Jacob to Israel, but he still addresses him as Jacob. The theological, if you will, the commitment mind in my study makes me want to wonder, why would God still call him Jacob when he called his name Israel? Well, the Lord told me today, he said, well, son, as long as you keep answering to who you were, I wish I had a praise up in here. He said, as long as you keep answering to who you were, people will always call you what you used to be. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. If I was in my church, I would be raw and transparent. But since I'm home, I might as well say, if you ain't a whore, stop answering to a whore. Why y'all looking at me funny? If you ain't nobody's dog, stop answering. It's gonna get quiet up in here. I know when I come to your church, I can't say it. Yeah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But what is it? He said, if you keep on responding to what you used to be, then they're going to keep calling you that very thing. And so the Lord now, watch this, you will. The Lord says to Jacob, he says, I want you to, watch Brother Kenny, I know you know the text, but Jacob here is deceiver and supplanter. But God changes his name to Israel, which means he's a prince with God. You got to stay with me, I'm almost there. And so now he addresses him for who he used to be. I was at a praise. But I hope you understand something. It was Jesus who said to Satan, he said, who do men say that I am? Let me go here if I can. He said, some say you are Elisha. Some say you are Jeremiah or one of the prophets. And so now Jesus getting real, if you will, intellectual on him. He says, but now who do you say that I am? I've heard what everybody else is saying, but have they convinced you to believe that I am who they said I am? I wish I had a praise. And so Simon said this. He said, thou art the Christ, Son of the living God. I wish I had a praise. Jesus says to Simon by Jonah, he says, flesh and blood could not reveal this unto you. Wait now, look who he addressed. He didn't address the apostle Simon. He addressed the man, Simon Bar-Jonah. Y'all ain't gonna help me. He addressed the one that was a cusser. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me up in here. He addressed the one that was ready to fight. I wish I had a praise. What do you say? I come to tell you, what a life, that God will use you while you are where you are. And no matter what you're going through right now, God still has a call on your life. I need you to help me tell it. God has a call on your life. If you came to lobby act tonight, you can be dismissed because glory is about to happen. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, God's going to use you where you are. You may not be dotting every I and crossing every T, but I come to tell you, what a life, that God's going to get the glory out of your life. But let me help you understand something now. You should not stay in sin because we have grace. The Bible says, shall I sin because grace abound? God for me. And so we have diluted the message of holiness and we swerved it for the message of the kingdom. Talking about the kingdom is living word, and the kingdom is in power, and the kingdom is about money. No, let me tell you what the kingdom is really about. John came saying, repent, for the kingdom is at hand. And then Jesus came after John saying the same thing John said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The very first message of the kingdom is that you repent. I wish I had a praise. So if you're going to experience kingdom living, you got to get out of your flesh. Hallelujah. You got to die to you. Why y'all looking at me for? Well, I don't drink but a little bit. Well, baby, the Bible said a little leaven the whole lump. Oh, I know we'll get real quiet in here. I ain't sleeping with but one man. The Bible said, I wish I had a praise of holiness for that. I can dance while y'all looking at me for it. Yeah. Holiness without no man shall see the Lord. Well, I don't cuss like I used to. Can I tell you, baby, that I believe that the only church on. So the Bible said, the Bible declares here that now God speaks to Jacob and he tells him this, watch this prophet if you will. He says, first of all, I want you to arise. In other words, he said, let it down, move from where you are. Stop being stuck where you are. He said, don't get too comfortable with being broke. Don't get too comfortable with being sick. He said, first of all, you must be planted in the house of God. Look what he told Jacob. He said, arise and go up to Bethel. Bethel in the Hebrew means the house of God. And so he says, before you come into manifestation, you got to be planted in the house of the Lord. And then he tells him, you got to follow me in the text. He says, and I want you to dwell there. Tell somebody, dwell there. Come on, say the power. Tell them, dwell there. You to dwell there. Dwell in the Hebrew here means yeshab. It means to settle. It means to remain. It means, watch this, it means to marry. Some folk treat the church like a natural relationship. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Or they treat it like a job that they no longer want. And they treat it like this. Whenever the church stop working for them, then they stop coming to church. They come telling lies. Come on, my season is up. Negro, I'm sorry, I thought I was in my church. You ain't did nothing but raise hell since you've been here. How your season up? I ain't got no praise in that. I ain't never seen. How is your season up? You ain't got no money. You ain't got no joy. You ain't got no peace. So that means you have no fruit. And if you don't have no fruit, you have no signs that you ever had a season. The way that you can tell that you have a season is when you got fruit. Look down your road and ask your neighbor, where is your fruit? Where is your fruit? I gotta get out of here. They don't like me in Florence, South Carolina. It means to marry. And so now, prophet, we got people who want to pimp our anointing, who want to use our gifts, who will come to our churches when they got cancer, when they got to lose their houses, when they lost their jobs. I ain't got no praise to see. When they help, we got four girlfriends, when they wife ain't doing right at home, when the children tripping, when the dog won't eat his kibbles and bits, I got praises. When the cat won't lay in his little box, then they come to our churches, utilizing our anointing. But the moment, hallelujah, you rebuke them, hallelujah, they're going to leave the church. I ain't scared of none of y'all in South Carolina. And y'all who came from North Carolina have been scared too. You rather die or you stay home. Good God from Zion. Let me help you understand something. You don't know when your season is. Your season is assigned to your man of God. Get out of here. No, I'm holy too. I'm saying too. God speaks to me. Sure that God speaks to you. But you've been assigned to a voice in the earth. You need to recognize the voice that's in your life. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, recognize your voice. I gotta get out of here. They don't like me here. And so dwell here means to marry. I promise you I won't hold you long because I'm really hungry. Dwell here means it means to marry. Once name no longer works for them.